When shopping for an executor, I'm sure you guys always gravitate towards Windows executors, but is that really the smart choice, especially when Bifron recently has been getting stronger and stronger, and there have been more band waves and more detections than ever? Well, today I'm going to be going over the pros and cons between Windows and emulators in 5 top points, and to get started off, we're going to go off on the biggest point, which of course is detections. So with the nature of Windows executors nowadays, detections are going to happen whether you like it or not. That's just gonna be a new part of Roblox executors. Now, if there's any executors claiming to be all 100% undetectable, right now, that doesn't exist. There might be some people saying that, but once a band wave comes, they'll probably get cooked. Now, there's plenty of good executors that, you know, do their best to avoid that, but it's just something that's gonna happen to at least a few people, because before, remember, there were no ban. I don't know if you guys remember, but that was the case. No one ever used to get banned. Now, some people are definitely gonna get banned, whether it's a lot or just a few. Bans are gonna happen with Windows executors. Now, that's not really a bad thing, you know? Just make an alt, just use an alt, and you'll be cooling. But what if you guys wanna auto farm on a main account on Blocktruth, for example? You wanna get to max level? How do you do that? Well, then you guys should probably use an emulator. And that's because right now, Roblox does not really care at all about emulator executors. It's not their priority. Right now, what they're worried about is Windows executors. And they're like, oh, whatever, leave the emulators. Who uses that anyway? So right now they're not doing any band waves or any bans of some sort. Unlike before, where emulators were like the top thing, that was the only option. Now that's like a lower option, so they don't pay as much attention to it. And therefore, it's way less chance of you getting banned if you're using an emulator. So in the sense of detections, I definitely suggest you guys use an emulator if you want to avoid bans. Now, if you don't really care about bans, doesn't really matter in this case, right? Because detections only matter if you don't want to get banned. If you don't care, then probably just go ahead and use Windows. But let's move on to the second point, which is price. Now, who doesn't miss the old days of Roblox exploiting, where everything was free? OG Colonel, he will be missed, all right? But anyway, nowadays everything is paid or has a giant key system. So when thinking about using an emulator or a Windows, price is a pretty big thing, because the cheapest Windows executor will probably run you maybe like $5 a week minimum, honestly. And that's pretty crazy to me. $5 a week, that's $20 a month, guys. Pretty expensive, all right? So, you know, if you guys don't have that type of money to be constantly pouring into executors, you might want to rethink whether using, you know, Windows executors is the best or emulators, because basically all emulator executors nowadays, or, you know, Android executors, all have very cheap lifetime options. Now, there are some free Windows executors, but you're not going to get the best experience for the free executors, because they're usually, most of them are a little bit less better in terms of script support and things like that. So if you guys are looking for the best possible script support, usually Android executors are pretty good. They have like 100% UNC, SUNC, whatever you wanna test. Usually their script support is pretty great. Although, you know, it is on Android or emulator, their script support is good for the price that you're paying, especially due to the fact there's a lot of lifetime keys available for all these Android cheats. So if you're on a really short budget and you want the best executor possible, probably emulator is gonna be your way to go, unless you like somehow get a crazy sale on a Windows cheat. But otherwise, you're gonna get like a mid-tier, kind of mid to high tier Windows executor for the same price you'd get like a lifetime Android emulator executor. So that's really up to you guys. If you think it's worth spending that extra money on a Windows executor, then you gotta do it. Otherwise, if you really are short on money and you do want still a premium license for some type of executor, emulator might be the way to go in terms of price. Now, experience. Yeah, I mean, you guys know what I'm gonna say. Obviously, using a Windows executor is much more good of an experience. You know, you have zero lag issues. Personally, I never have lag issues on emulators, but you know, some people do. It is emulating a whole new device on your computer, so that's just gonna add a whole lot of lag for no reason. So using just a native Windows executor is gonna be way better in terms of lag. You also have the thing of resolution. Emulator resolutions are so terrible. I don't know how they manage it. It's like 720p or worse. Like, it's so blurry on emulators. But on Windows executors, you have that crisp, nice UIs that have, you know, acrylic settings. But on emulator, you get none of that. None of that. All that is out the door. So in terms of experience and the, you know, how pleasant it is to use an executor, Windows definitely wins. So there's another point for Windows. Now it's tied, you know, 1.5, 1.5, they're both pretty good as of now. But if we move on to setup slash software support, we come back to the point of some people not really being able to use emulator executors on their PCs just because they're lower end and they can't emulate a whole nother device on that same computer, which causes just crazy lag, and they can't really, you know, enjoy their time using a script because they're like on 5 FPS. So obviously in that case, emulators are not great. And you know, if that's what's happening for you guys, at the same time, you know, Windows executors might not run the greatest, but they should definitely run better than an emulator executor if that's the type of issues you're having. Additionally, setup can be pretty iffy depending on the executor. Now on Windows, it should be pretty straightforward, especially for more popular executors. I mean, it's just one exe, you double click, run, and you're good, you're ready to go. But on emulators, if you don't know what you're doing, it can be a little confusing because, you know, you gotta install an APK, kind of overwrite Roblox, and then you gotta re-log in to Roblox, and then you gotta make sure that little window pops up. So there's a few more steps, so it can be more confusing if you guys aren't used to that. But overall, if your PC is not the best and it lags, then probably emulators are not gonna work out for you because it's gonna be very laggy. So in that case, Windows probably also takes the cake in this one. So Windows is in the lead. You know, I would say that's kind of expected though. But the last point, which Windows might be in danger here, okay, which is viruses. Now, you guys know the classic, it's a classic, virus rats. Who doesn't know about them? I'm sure we've all experienced it at one point or another. I was trying to get one of my friends to download Kernel at some point. This was a while ago. And he started downloading all these different random ads. His computer was cooked by the end of it. So it is definitely an iffy experience downloading executors, especially free ones, okay? No hate to the free executors. You gotta make money somehow to pay developers, right? So you gotta do what you gotta do in terms of having ads on it. Otherwise, if you don't have ads on an executor, then I'm gonna be worried because how are you getting money, you know? So in this case, emulators, pretty good because, you know, you guys usually, if you're using an emulator, you don't really use that device for anything else other than just, you know, random games, you know, just random mobile games. So you don't have anything sensitive on there. Therefore, usually if you install some type of strange APK that, you know, is weird, it's not gonna do anything because, you know, what are they gonna take? Your Roblox account with 2FA on it, what are they gonna do? They can't do anything. So using an emulator, and in terms of potential infections on emulators, the risk is next to zero, unless it's some really advanced type of thing that, you know, is like crazy. Unless it's that situation, 9 times out of 10, you'll be 100% safe on an emulator, no matter what you download. It'll just mess up the emulator and that'll be about it. All your personal files, all your other websites will be completely safe because it's like a virtual box. It's an emulated device on your computer. But on Windows, if you download something wrong, you're cooked, okay? Because that's going on your whole system. So in that situation, it's way more dangerous to use a Windows executor. Now, if you know what you're doing and you double check your download, because even me personally, I've wanted to look for like certain executors in the past, and I'm like, oh, what's the download link for that? I don't know. And I search it up. Most of the downloads on Google are gonna be some fake website that some random person made and just put a virus in it. So you guys gotta be real careful for Windows executors, and you gotta make sure you're getting the right link from the right people. And that's one thing about Windows that makes them lose a point. And with that, guys, it looks like a tie. I did not intend for it to be a tie, but honestly, the experiences, there's trade-offs, you know? It's not just only positives or only negatives for one or another. There's trade-offs. Windows is better at a certain things, and emulators have some other pros in other areas. So it's really just a preference thing and what fits you the most. Because based off the criteria I listed, guys, some of those things might apply to you, like the PC thing. You guys might have a NASA PC, and the next person has like a, you know, laptop that was like $50 from 2001, right? So it's a different situation. One person will want Windows, the other person probably should not care because, you know, you're gonna get the same amount of performance on an emulator, and in terms of, you know, not getting 5 frames a second, you'll get the full amount. So it really just depends on the person, but hopefully this helped you guys out. If you guys want to get a free emulator executor, you can check out Yvonne right there in that video where I show you exactly step by step how to get an executor for yourself for free. It has a key system and premium for only $20. So that's a month key for Windows executors. It's a bargain. Or you can also check out out that video right there on how to get a Windows executor, which is also free, but you know, has a key system. So check one of those out, guys. Thank you for sticking along till the end, and I'll catch you in one of those videos right there. Bye-bye.